We have received a lot of messages from many people, and social media is awash with people wanting to know why is it that Prophet Advocate Joshua is that close to Mr. Pardon Gambakwe. Let me clear the air. You see, Mr. Pardon Gambakwe is one of the few individuals who have actually blessed the prophet's life. I must say, as a prophet, I don't know 5 people who are like him. He's a man of very fine character qualities. He's not a combination of fire and gas. I must say, he's a very calm individual. And I also know him as an early bird. This I know for certain. He wakes up 3 a.m. daily. He's an industrious individual. You see, in life you need people like that, because I recall in the Bible when a lady comes and pours oil on Jesus, expensive oil, and the disciples were complaining, saying, we could have sold this oil and given to the poor. Jesus says, the poor you shall always have, but me, I shall not always be there with you. What did Jesus actually mean? In life, you need people who respect the anointing or what you carry. And as a prophet, I must say that Mr. Pardon Gambakwe is one of the very few individuals who have worked for God in respecting one and in anointing God's vessel with oil. And he's a very rare kind of species, I must say. You don't find people like Mr. Gambakwe in the ordinary course of events. He's a rare person, personality, I must say. So I, as a prophet, I thank God for the blessing, because to me, I don't only see him as a son, but I see him as a blessing in my life. Yes, where you find a good person, there's always going to be somebody there out there to criticize or destroy the image. Jesus was criticized. But Mr. Pardon Gambakwe, I've experienced him. I know him. He's a person that I personally envy as a prophet. I don't even doubt his social media capabilities in the media platform. No wonder why he's very dominant in the media arena. Because the manner in which he handles himself, the manner in which he handles his career, is something that is out of this world. He's an industrious person. I see kindness in his eyes. And he's one of the people that when I get into my prayer closet, I pray for him. Because God, in remembering me, he placed people like Mr. Pardon Gambakwe. You see, we have to learn to appreciate our heroes in life. You see, you don't find Jonathan anywhere unless you pray unto God. And when God blesses you with a Jonathan, learn to appreciate them. A lot of people, that's the problem that they have. They can't appreciate their heroes. They can't appreciate those who have sacrificed for them. You see, Mr. Pardon Gambakwe realized that God speaks through me in a major way in this world. He took the gospel, he took the voice of God, and he publicized it. He made it known. In other words, he knows it. I actually have called him an evangelist at some point in time. He noticed how much people didn't know that God speaks to me in a unique way in our generation. He took the gospel, put it upon himself to expose the word of God and, you know, give it to the people. So he became a transporter of the word, the prophetic word. So that's Mr. Pardon Gambakwe for you. I'm going to come back in another episode explaining even more detail that you might not have known. If you are somebody who wants to grow, find out about him. Check what kind of a person he is. Google about him. He's a marvelous personality to know. And for the young generation, I encourage you to emulate people like Mr. Pardon Gambakwe. God bless you.